Adults Now Online channel. Today we want to look at parallelogram law of vector. Now, you see, when we have two different vectors, you know, in our last class we talked more about vectors and how we can represent vectors and the types of vectors that we have. Today we want to look at what? If I'm given two vectors, let me say this is vector A, which is magnitude and direction, and I have another vector, which is what? Vector B. But it's acting in different directions to each other. This is my vector B. Now I want to look at how can we add these two vectors together to get a single vector. Now, you see, unlike scalar quantities can be added algebraically. Simply means by using your normal addition. If assuming I have the magnitude of this vector A is taken as A, as an assumption, I have a vector A and I have what B, I can add these two together in normal mathematical manner. Simply means you can add this using what? Algebraic. By saying if this thing is representing 2 and this one is representing what? 3, then it can easily be added to give what? 5. This is ordinary what? Scalar addition. But vectors, two or more vectors cannot be added together using what? Scalar addition. In adding two or more vectors together, we make use of what we call what? Parallelogram law of vector. Now we are here. You see, what does this mean? According to the law, it said if two vectors are represented in magnitude and direction, in magnitude and direction, with the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram, comma, the resultant vector will be represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal of the parallelogram. Now let's take a look at what the law is trying to tell us. You see, if I'm given two vectors, let's say vector A and vector B, that are represented in magnitude and direction. Simply means they both have the magnitude and direction with two adjacent sides of the parallelogram. Let's say we have two vectors A here. This is a vector A that is acting towards this direction, and I have vector B. The two vectors are adjacent to each other. They met at a single point here. Let's assume that what these vectors are representing, we have A and what? B. These are two different vectors. Then, to add these two vectors together, we can only add it using what? By constructing a parallelogram with the vector. If I assume that I draw a line that is parallel to vector B, another line that is parallel to vector A, in this manner, I'm sorry, to this vector A, that's what this law is trying to say. That was, if two vectors are represented in magnitude and direction with the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram, this is two adjacent sides of what? Parallelogram. Now, we said a resultant vector is a vector which will have the same magnitude and it is going to have what? The same point of application, or let me say, it is a vector which will have the same effects as the other two vectors that I was taking together. That's what we call resultant vector. For example, now, this is what I mean by that. Assuming the vector that we are adding together is a force vector, then the resultant must surely be a force. Simply means the resultant will never be what? Acceleration or velocity. Or neither it be what? Momentum. Simply means, now, if I'm adding velocity together, I'm going to get what? A velocity. That is what the resultant means. So if you come back to this parallelogram law, it said of a parallelogram, the resultant vector will be represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal. Now, you see, diagonal of a parallelogram. It is a line that is drawn from one edge of the parallelogram to other edge of the parallelogram. Let me say this line in this place here. We call this one the diagonal. Now, so what we are trying to say is that if I have this, let me say this arrow is moving like this, this should be parallel to this, and this should be what? Parallel to what? To this. So if you have two vectors that are represented in magnitude and direction, then the diagonal should represent the resultant vector. That is what parallelogram law of vector is all about. But let's take a look at how to add these vectors together using this parallelogram law. Now, this is what it says. Assuming I have a vector, taking a look at this parallelogram here. Now, I can add this vector A with vector B. Please note, before I forget, vectors are always added from edge to tip. It simply shows that if I have vector A towards the direction, this is the what? The tail of the vector, while here is the edge of the vector. Now, the tail of one vector, or let me say the head of one vector coincides with the tail of the other vector. Simply means to add two vectors together, the tail and the head must coincide with each other. This is what I mean by what? Coincidence. I have vector A and I have what? Vector B in this manner, or let me say in this direction, vector B. Now, this is the tail of vector B, this is the head of vector B. From here, I can add vector A with vector B. In adding them, I'm going to place it. This, if vector A is stopping here, then that should be the starting point for what's vector B. Then, this is the end point of this vector. I can close this form of vector here. We have what we call a closed vector. It simply shows that what a vector sometimes can be open vector and it can be what a closed vector. This kind of vector that is here is an open vector. Why is it open? It is because when I added these two vectors together, the starting point and the end point does not join each other. It simply shows that what I can only join them together by joining what the drawing a vector from the starting point to the what end point. This vector that is drawn from the starting point to the end point is what we call the resultant vector. If here is vector A, here is vector B, then this is the resultant of what? A and B. Simply shown that what? These two vectors, vector R, is equal to addition of vector A plus what? Vector B. Please note, if I write A plus B, please, this addition is different from adding A plus B, which is the magnitude, ordinary pure number, and adding the what? Magnitude of a vector. They are typically what? Different. Take for instance, difference between, if I have what? A scalar, 3 plus 4 can give rise to what? 7. But if it is a vector, if this quantity is used to represent a vector, then a vector 3 and what? 4 should give rise to what? 5. Let me say, I have 3 Newton force and what? 4 Newton force. If I add these two force together vectorially, I'm going to get what? 5 Newton force. But if I add it using what? Scalar, 3 Newton force plus 4 Newton force is going to give what? 7 Newton force, which are two different what, things entirely. It shows that what? Vectors, addition of vectors, does not obey algebraic law. Now, taking a look at this here, vectors A, I said R is equal to what? A plus B. That means if you check into my parallelogram, it looks alike. I have vector A starting from here, I mean, vector B is also having what? Starting from that point. I can move this vector to this place here, which here, this one will tell me that what? This is my vector B. Now, if I add this vector A plus B, which is the starting point, should be connected to the what? Last point. I have my vector R, which is equal to A plus B. Also, likely, vector can be what? Twisted. You know, here should be what? A. I have here should be. If I add these two together, B plus A, it's going to give me what? Vector B plus A. The resultant is still what? The same resultant. That is how we add what? Two or more what? Vectors together using the parallelogram law of addition of vector. Now, this same parallelogram law is also applicable if you have more than what? One vector. That means if I have, this one is two vectors. If I'm having three vectors, although the parallelogram law is applicable, but the best thing that we can use if you have more than what? Two vectors, we can simply use a triangle law. You see, a triangle law is a part of parallelogram law.
simply means putting the parallelogram into different forms of what? Triangle, then applying the word law. In my next video, we are going to look into triangular vectors and also the polygon law of vector. Please try to watch the next video and you get what? More fun of it. Thank you very much. Please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel.